One of the important things in marketing, especially when we talk about email marketing, is that we should set different email marketing automation campaigns. The campaigns that they run by itself, depending on what customers or users do on our website or on our application. Okay, so it's really important to understand how we should set up these automation, these email marketing automation campaigns. But beside that, we also can learn a lot from the market, okay, from the top marketers that they're doing this system, they're running the same system for their own products. We can learn it from them. So what I did a couple of days ago, I went on 2-3 websites, right, that they were good at email marketing, like the website of Ty Lopez, right, Dan Luck, and for example, also on ClickFunnels. I went on their website and I tried to sign up on their email list. So as you saw here, right, after a couple of seconds, like 10 seconds on Ty Lopez's website, this pop-up appeared, right? And here it is asking me for my email and my phone number, right? And if I write this information here and click on continue, it will give me a PDF or something, a reward. This way they will capture my email and then they send me some random reward. It doesn't matter much, okay, at this point. So I can come here and learn this system myself from what they did, right? So for example, I can create the same pop-up instead of sign up or subscribe. You see here it's wrote continue. Okay, these are all small psychological things which have huge impact in marketing. The same goes for Dan Luck. Okay, there are many different stuff here, right, different offers, but here at the beginning there are a lot of attention around this button, okay? It is forcing me to just click on this button, download for free, okay? So if I click on it, then it will jump on a landing page, download now for zero, okay? If I click on it, then it will ask for my name, for my email, and how much I make, okay? And I can create the same thing for myself, for my product as well. Now, the important thing here that we are going to talk about is not these pop-ups to capture emails, okay? You can learn from it as well. But the important things are the emails themselves, okay? To understand how these emails, email marketing automation campaigns were created, how they designed it, okay? So what I did, as I mentioned, a couple of days ago, I did this. The same thing, I went on this website and sign up on their emails, right? Sign up on their email list. And I received some emails right at that day. And after that, I received some other emails. So what we're going to do here, okay, we're going to come, for example, for Dan Luck, okay, I'm going to come here. And this is the email he sent me, right? You see, it's very clear, very understandable. We don't have big paragraphs, right? And here there's a call to action. There's a video, which if I click on it, also they put the link here. Talk to you tomorrow, right? I'm gonna expecting another email tomorrow. It's very clear, very understandable, right? And also they have another product here. If you wanna sign up on our live event, you can come here and click on it, right? All right, so this is their live event, so it is closed right now. We can join the waitlist and so on. Okay, so if I click on it, it will jump on another landing page which they have their video running, right? Okay, and some other offers here and some feedbacks, social proof, right? Now our focus here in this lecture is just on emails. So how we can understand or how we can learn from these email sequences and we can get the good things out of it and implement it on our own email marketing sequence. So we can come here. Here I prepared a Google Doc file, okay? And I can copy and paste the email that I receive in the sequence that it has, and then upload it on ChatGPT or Claude and ask them to analyze it and then create the same thing for my product, whatever your product is, okay? It doesn't matter. So I'm just gonna come here. First, I'm gonna copy the subject and paste it. Okay, let me just, before pasting. All right, so now I'm gonna copy the whole email content, right? And come here and paste the content here. All right, the format is not as I expected, so we can come here and we can print it, right? Let's print it. So here is the printed version, okay? Or we can, let's do it this way. I'm gonna just copy the rest of it, right? And print it this way. Now we have the subject, right? We have the subject, we have the date inside it, and I'm gonna save this as, for example, all right, the name of the file is also the subject of the email. This is perfect. Okay, I'm gonna save this, right? Let's go back to emails, and I'm gonna close this. We don't need it anymore. So this was the first email that I got, right? Now this was the second email. As you can see, it is in video 2, find the gap, right? Now I'm gonna just do the same thing here. And as you can see, they are now, they have two parts, two promotion at the bottom of the emails, right? So they warmed me up as a subscriber or as a user. And now they are just offering different products to me. They're just showing it to me. So I get familiar with it, and little by little, I will get convinced to purchase these products. Okay, so I'm gonna print this as well. Right, and I think the name will be, yeah, the subject of the email. Let's go back to our emails. And here we should have, this should be the third email or not. I'm not sure. I think not. Okay, let's come here. Probably I didn't receive the third email yet, okay? So I can wait a couple of days, right, to receive 4, 5, 6, 10 emails that they have, right, on their email sequence. And what I can do, I can come on ChatGPT. Let's open a new ChatGPT, or let's stick to the file we had here, okay? I can come here. So I'm gonna click on the files here and go to resources, email marketing, and I'm just gonna rename it and add numbers to it. So ChatGPT understand which one is number one and which one is number two, day one, day two. All right, let's do it this way, day one, day two. Okay, day two, right? And this one will be day one. Day one, okay? So I'm gonna select them and add them to my ChatGPT, and then mention that these are, for example, this is an email sequence of one of my competitors, or this is an example of email marketing automation, and I want you to do the same for my own product. I mentioned that I attached two files, right, two PDF files, and each one contained an email I received from Danlog's website, right? And I explained the situation. I received these emails after I signed up on their email list to receive a free PDF as a gift, right, for high ticket sales and marketing and stuff like that. Now I want you to analyze these emails and with the same structure and same strategies, create a 5-day marketing, email marketing automation plan for me, right, for my product, whatever it is, okay? And on day 4 and 5, I want to promote our product, okay? Of course, if you have the whole sequence, like day 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever it is, okay? ChatGPT or Claude, they can do a better job designing this email marketing sequence, right? But here's also fine, okay? So, welcome and free resource delivery. This is the subject, okay, from my first email. And this is just an outline for the email, I think, right? So, these are the outline for the email. We have greeting and confirmation, resource delivery, right? Next step and call to action. Day two, the same way. Day three, the same way. Day four, the same way, and so on. Now I'm going to ask ChatGPT to write the content for the first email. So I mentioned write the first email contents, right? This with the same structure as I uploaded. And here it is just offering me two options, but that doesn't matter. Usually ChatGPT does this, that they offer two options and ask you to select the best one, right? So that's good for us. We have two options here. Now, one of the things that you see its problem here, if you pay attention to Dan Lok's email, let's go to the first day. As I told you before, we have just simple lines, okay? We don't have paragraphs, right? But here, for example, on the second example, we have paragraphs, which I don't like it, right? Here, it's better, but still, I don't like it. I'm going to select this one, okay? Right? But I can ask ChatGPT to make the first couple of lines shorter. Okay, I mentioned that it is good, but make the first couple of lines shorter so users can keep reading. Okay, I'm gonna still, I think this should be shorter, but anyway, it's much better, right? So here we have our welcome, then the downloadable guide here. So here is the, for example, if it is a video or if it is a PDF, here they can click on it and download it. And what's next, right? Let's dive in. See you tomorrow. P.S. We have a live event. You can sign up on it and we're going to make some money here as well. Okay. Now with the same structure, go for the second email, go for the third email and so on. Okay. Now you can get the content, right? And go on different platforms like MailChimp, GetResponse. Okay. And create email marketing automation. But in case if you don't know how it should look like, you can jump on Cloud. Okay. Cloud do a really good job on creating this and ask Cloud to create an email marketing automation sequence for you. Okay. It will create the diagram for you and it will make your work much easier. So I'm just going to come back here where we uploaded the PDFs, right? I'm just going to copy them and upload them on Cloud and ask Cloud to do the same thing. Let's select the files, right? And submit it. All right. So it will analyze it. Then I will ask Cloud to write the first email content. And then I will ask it to create the diagram for the email marketing automation. I will just fast forward to the point which we get to the email marketing automation sequence. So for some reason, it didn't complete the task on browser, but I also have the Cloud application on my computer. Sometimes these issues happen, right? So I uploaded them there, right? And it is writing the first email, right? Without me asking to write the content of the email, it is writing day one, day two, day three, day four, and day five, okay? Now I'm going to write down until it is getting complete the first task. Right, I'm gonna write down to create the email marketing sequence diagram. Now I want you to create a complete and detailed email marketing automation sequence diagram for the emails you wrote. Okay, now it's the interesting part of Cloud, which ChatGPT can't do this part, right? It will write the codes for the diagram so we can have the diagram if it works right now. Every time that I want to record a lecture and talk about a topic, this happens a lot. Now it began. That I'm just going to show you something on a platform. Right, you come here and you click on this button and it will happen this. And boom, nothing happens. You were working for more than a year and now that I'm recording, you don't work anymore? Why? So this happens a lot. In my courses, I'm just recording a new lecture and the thing that it should work, it doesn't work. Okay. Anyway, it happens in life. So things that you plan out may not work as we expected. So here is a diagram, right? We can zoom in or we can just go full screen. So here is the lead magnet to download the PDF or get the reward, whatever it is. And then the user come on our welcome email. They will receive it, right? If they opened it, then they will go for the rest of the system, right? If they click on the video, right? On the video inside the email, what will happen? If they download the PDF, what will happen? And then here we have email day two. If they didn't open it, this will happen. If they open, this will happen, and it will go forward for day three and so on. Here we have the purchase product. Okay. And if you're not happy with the result of the diagram, you can ask Cloud to make some changes the way you want it to be. And if you're happy with it, you can just download it. And for example, if you want to create an email marketing automation, as I mentioned, you have to use one of the email marketing platforms. Here, there is a website, MailerLite. Okay, I haven't used it yet, but it was interesting for me. I wanted to try it out. So you can come to automation. The other email marketing providers are the same. Okay, I can come here and click on create. And here, for example, simple welcome email. Okay, I come here, right? So it more or less looks like the same diagram that we have here, but a little bit with different looks. Okay, so here we have it. Let's go for the next one, right? Wait, for example, for 3 days, then do this, then send this email. If they didn't open it, send this email. If they opened it, send another email, right? We can add it this way. So it's, I think it's a tutorial, right? Oh, all right. I thought it's a tutorial. We have to select template. It was the different sides of this template. Okay. So here we have our, for example, the first step, which here it was. Let me zoom in and also go full screen. So here we have the lead magnet download. Okay. Which is start the first trigger to send the first email. Here we have welcome email day one. Okay. I can rename the stuff based on that. So I can come here. This is the title, right? What was it? Welcome email day one. Welcome email day one. Okay. And then I can go to design email. Oh, first we need to verify our email since I haven't used this platform and I'm just testing it out. I have to do it later. Okay. Then you can come here, click on design email. Another page will open and you can just put the content of your email there and go with the same flow, right? And as I said, on different platforms, if you go on GetResponse, more or less you get the same thing, okay, with the different colors and different UI and different looks. If you go on MailChimp, you more or less get the same thing, okay? So don't panic, all of them are the same. Just you can go through it, you can search on YouTube for some additional tutorial on how to use different email marketing platforms, right? But the whole the main thing here was the structure of your email, okay? The structure of your email marketing sequence and what will happen if they don't open it or if they open it, right? And the content of the email itself. This is the important part. This is the part which convinced the user to open your gift, receive it, like it, or purchase your product in the future, okay? This is the important part. So that was all for this lecture. As I said, it became a little bit longer than usual, but I wanted it to be all in one package. Okay, so I hope you liked it and see you soon on the next part.